pretty decent place as far as being satisfied with my life. It wasn't so much, you know, that it wasn't complete or anything, but I started wanting something more. Like before, right after the divorce, the second divorce, I was just out there and just having fun, but really spending a lot of time with my kids. And I was really lucky and blessed. The men that I did date, they were good men. They were nice men, kind, sweet. Some maybe a little bit more serious than I was at the time, or some definitely just, you know, what we hear all the time. I'm just having fun. I'm just having a good time. But after a while, I started wanting a little bit more. And when I met Carl, I was in a state of mind of patience. Let's just wait and see how things happen.
2013 was the year of hell. I mean, I had gone through a tumultuous divorce, and not the divorce is easy for anybody because it's tough and it's like death for anyone, most anyone who goes through it. But for me, it was particularly debilitating because of what it had done to my psyche as a man. I left the feeling that I was inadequate as a man, that I could never be a good husband, which is something that I've always wanted to be because of the amount of money I made and the type of business I chose to get into, that I could never, you know, provide for a wife. I was really going through a lot of questions, second guessing of my own worthiness as a man and as a husband, and wasn't in a good place. Now, by the time I met Latonya, though, I was on the upside of that. I was still going through it, but I was on the upside of it. You know, I didn't see myself, even though I have the heart of a husband, I didn't think that I was
could do it again
emotionally, but also I didn't think that I could provide. And that whole thing about provision and with men today in 2014 is so tricky. And I look around and a lot of my friends are doing so well in the financial sense. You know, they own homes, they have nice cars and all that stuff. And those things are great. And I've had those things before, actually. But it's just, I didn't think that I could really do it.
Because he definitely wasn't ready for a relationship either. And I just wasn't in a frame of mind of pushing or wanting something to happen so fast. I know a lot of times, you know, I want a relationship. God, I want a man. I wasn't like that. I was fine. And it was just something about it. I don't know. It was so easy. And it was so, I was so sure. It's weird. I've never been so sure of something. Like before, I had doubts. I always had doubts. But then, you know, that little small voice, you override it all the time. But in this case, it was weird. I had no doubts whatsoever. And so here we are, year one, and it has been quite a ride. Definitely no regrets at all. No buyer's remorse. Okay, so yeah, we definitely have our heart, discussions and, you know, fair fights. But I wouldn't trade it for anything. I wouldn't trade it for anything. I love my life the way it is right now. It's a very good feeling. I haven't had one of those excited Christmases in a long time. Yeah. And it's because my children are happy. I'm happy. I guess you're happy.
I am. Yes, I am.
But it feels good.
Yeah.
You know? And we don't have the millions yet, but I wouldn't trade this right now for anything in the world.
I was at a party, a Kwanzaa party. Might have been about a year ago exactly to the day we got married. We got married on December 28th. So that Kwanzaa party had to be 20th of December of 2013. And at that party, Latonya walked up to me and, you know, I just noticed that she was pretty, but I didn't think much of it. She walked up and introduced herself as my Facebook friend, and I remember her name, but not her face necessarily, and went home and made a mental note of her so I can say, okay, the next time I see her, I will know who Latonya Black is, and I can act like I am a human being, so to speak. So, you know, at the time I met her at the party, you know, the whole marriage idea was totally out of the question. I was ready to just date, have a good time with whomever wanted to be in my space, and we liked each other. But no marriage, because I didn't have the money to provide for a wife, and I didn't have the castle to provide for her, or the dowry, so to speak, that whole thing. And you know, look, all men go through that, but I think society even pushes it more. And in the case of my last marriage, it was something that was really pushed heavily and was in my spirit. So I kind of thought that I was a loser in the husband department. And it kind of met by happenstance on social media, and the rest is history. I mean, by the time we met up in person and had breakfast at the now famous Moe's in Toluca Lake, it was done. I mean, we just never separated. And 6 months after we had that first meal together, we were married, and I still didn't have that dowry, so to speak. But you know, God brings people together for a reason, and it has been nothing but incredible. Yeah, you know, we have differences. I mean, I'm a man, and I'm a very strong-willed person, but Latonya is a perfect person for me in terms of keeping me centered and bringing me back to a place of normalcy and love. Getting back to love, that's her thing, and she keeps me there.
I'm the type of woman, though, I would rather build something with you. I find it kind of awkward to come into a situation where, you know, he's already got a house and all this stuff is going on, you know, and I have to come in and try to like make it my own, you know, or ours.
Right.
And I like to build stuff together. Well, everybody's got their own ways of working together. And for some people, it works when you have, you know, your money separate all over the place. And then you have one little joint account. It's like nobody trusts one another. And women have this thing in the back of their heads, you know, you gotta have a just-in-case account, you know.
Right.
I had women, I heard my aunts and people say that all the time, you know, that little secret account. But to me, I think you set yourself up for failure that way, you know, because you're planning. It's almost like you're planning on it not to work. Sure. Some people have this mindset that things don't last forever, but if you do, you shouldn't get married because you already know it won't work.
Well, that's the thing that what you're talking about there, and how people do their money and how they do their marriages, whatever works for you.
Well, it works. Some people work better when it's
but the,
separate.
But the whole thing is that the whole idea of oneness, which is what marriage is about, and which is really, you know, what you really helped me with, because in the past, you know, whenever there was a mistake made, or whenever anything happened with the money, I was blamed for it, and then it went over to a separate thing again. And that just kind of has that thing in your mind. You're always saying, you know, I'm going to be out of here in a minute. And if you cannot trust the man or woman you're marrying,
yeah,
then
don't
just stay
do
single.
It.
You just stay single. Why do that to yourself?
You have to know that before.
It's a slow death. Yeah.
Yeah, because you get in a situation where, you know, money can always kill a relationship, a friendship, a family relationship, everything. And you have to be careful even before you go in it. Maybe one of you don't have the best spending habits, but as long as one of you do, then you kind of, you know, sharpen each other. And if you choose well, that person's going to learn from you, and you're going to learn from him. So it's always, you got to stay open, and you got to see it as a team. I tell you, it never works unless you see this as a team.
But the thing that you said, and this is kind of touching on the same thing you said earlier, which really gives me a great sense of comfort. And this was something that I did not have. You know, this is my third marriage. First marriage was 13 years. And the second marriage was 11 years. And there was something that both those marriages had that were in common. From the standpoint of the actual marriage, I really wasn't able to be myself. The person just wasn't happy with me as I am on some level. The first marriage, it was, you know, more about the romantic pull she had. She wasn't feeling me, you know, romantically. And I fought that for almost the entire time. And then the second one was my finances. It was always a problem with my finances, my ability to produce money on an inconsistent basis. And that was always a bone of contention. On both times, I felt myself trying to adjust to please those people, and it just did not work. This is the first time that I can be myself. I feel that I can be who I am, and we are going on the journey of life together. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's the same thing with you. I mean, I don't try to make you do or be, but I've always kind of had that gift. That's the one thing with all of my faults, that I've always been good at that, building people, you know, wanting people to be the best they can be. And that's what we have. That's what I love.
We both have a different level of maturity to them.
Yeah,
you know, on our own parts.
Right.
Well, my first one, I was just way too young. He's a good guy, but we were just way too young. Didn't even know who we were yet.
Right.
And the second one, 16 years. Just a lot of growing also in that one. But, well, a lot of things that were just toxic. And sometimes when you're loyal to a fault, you know, you tend to put yourself in a situation where you totally lose yourself in order to make something work.
Right.
And then when that doesn't work, you know, because eventually that never works. Mm-hmm. Because if you're a half person, half everything, you don't bring your whole self to the relationship.
Right.
So we all did a lot of growing, you know, a lot of maturing. And here we are, 2015.
1 year in, 2016, and happy birthday. Thank you. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
It's her birthday. You cannot mix up Christmas with Latonya's birthday.
My birthday is on December 25th.
Okay, it's Jesus' birthday. Happy birthday, Jesus. You know, we're going to give gifts for that. Okay, Jesus is done. Now it's your birthday. We're going to separate the two. And then our anniversary is on Monday, the 28th.
Yes.
And we're going to do something.
He won't tell me what we're going to do.
We're going to do something.
He already has a trip planned. He won't tell me where we're going.
I didn't say it was a trip. Did I say we're going to trip? Oh, yes. You're going to trip on your face? We'll never have you. I would never trip you like that. You mean a trip? Like we're going to go on a trip.
But we hope that we've... You're so retarded. We hope we've been a blessing to you. And...
What else? Anything
just
else?
Just have a wonderful, wonderful Christmas and a blessed new year. And all of my friends, thank you so much for all of your love and support.
Yes.
Thank you. And all of my new friends. I met so many people.
Oh, you did. I'm sorry.
Since married to this guy. But it's a new family.
Yes.
And everybody out there, I love you all. And gosh, there's a lot of my family members that I still haven't even seen yet. Like physically laid eyes on. I talked to them, but I haven't seen them. So 2016 is going to be a great, great year for us.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
New year. Or as you say, Marvtastic New Year.
Marvtastic.
So we're going to be out. It's another conversation with Carl and Latonya, the anniversary edition. 2015 is on the outs. Happy New Year, and I love you.
And I love you too. And make your new year happen now. Make your great moments happen now. Don't make resolutions. Don't wait till January 1st. Do it now.
And be positive.
Yes.
And believe the best about yourselves.
Yes.
Because you are the best and God created you. All right, so we out.
We love you.
Peace. Two fingers. What's your name again?
Four.
What's your name?
Gilliard's out.
I'm Carl Gilliard.
I'm Latonya.